time for medal race three on this first medal day here in Aarhus in Denmark, and it's the 470 women about to get underway, our third medal race of the day, and it's happening just beyond that forest and the hill over on the water, right in front of the race village, where the crowds have come in their hundreds to cheer them on. And that is the course. The 470 women with 2 minutes and 20 seconds to go to the start. The 470, a class, well, so close to Japanese hearts, and we've seen success for them in the men's already. This fleet is led by a Japanese team going into the medal race. Can they keep their cool in the limelight? This is how the women go into their medal race here in Aarhus. The Japanese out in front, Camille Lecointre and Aloise Ritonaz of France in second, Hannah Mills and Ailie McIntyre in third place at the moment. But it's all pretty close. And the top four can all win gold. That is the pressure on those sailors there with the yellow bibs, the Japanese who are out in front. But they have got, well, they've got Olympians, they've got world champions breathing down their necks. It's going to be tough.
Definitely. You know, I love the sentence of the Japanese team, we love Aarhus, and I hope Aarhus loves us today. Yeah, very experienced sailor, and looking forward to seeing them racing.
Our overall leaders there from Japan, Aikondo Yoshida and Miho Yoshioka, they're the ones to catch. We've got the blue bibs of Camille Lecointre and Aloise Ritonaz in second place overall with 40 seconds to go. How's the start line looking, Jordan?
Yeah, pretty square. Slight advantage to the pin end, the port side of the line away from the committee boat. The wind is just back around 120 degrees. Course is just on the 1 kilometre. It's anywhere on the line at the moment, maybe just down to the pin end slightly.
Eight different nations on the start line here, so all available qualifications places for Tokyo 2020 have been claimed. So the race is about world titles for the sailors, and the Japanese start with gold in their grasp and right at this boat end of the start line.
Yep, got somebody over the line.
So someone is over early. Yeah. As the fleet set off, spread out right across the start line. I think it was the Slovenians of Mrak and Makarol. We'll get confirmation shortly. Yep, Slovenia 64 is out of the race. They were over the line early. It's not allowed. And that's the X flag telling them that their race is over.
Yeah, we actually see that the British team of Hannah Mills and McIntyre is also returning.
Ah, so they're starting again. So it's a toss-up, isn't it? That flag flies, you've got to guess. Was it me over the line or was it somebody else?
Yeah, you just know that somebody or more than one boat is over the line, and then it has to be your own judgment call whether or not you think you were over. And if you think you were over, you can make up for that and go back under the starting line and start the race again. But this does mean that they have a disadvantage at the moment because they're quite far behind.
So the Slovenians trying to recover from that terrible start.
The Japanese rolled very quickly off that start line onto port, heading out to the right side of the course. And they're travelling nicely. They've probably got more speed than anyone in the fleet at the moment and looking quite happy.
Yeah, so confirmation that Mills and McIntyre had no need to come back and restart. They weren't over early. But they decided not to take the risk. So these are our top four in the 470 women's. The Japanese top left corner and the red bibs of the British bottom left.
Yeah, there's only 4 points separating the British Mills and McIntyre from the Spanish team, De Paris and Cantero Rena. So that does mean that the British have to climb up the ranking a little bit to hold on to the podium position.
There's not many passing lanes out here today either, Evie. You know, like there's not big shifts. It's just
yeah, I know. It's a very day. Very stable, yeah. Not much difference in wind speed and in wind angle, it's the same. So it's all about those details.
Yeah.
We've seen a real variety of weather. Pretty much every day has been different through these championships. And that's led to a variety of results as well. But here, for this medal race, we've got perfect conditions with steady breeze and sunshine. And we're watching the leaders, Yoshida and Yoshioka of Japan, making their way up this first leg, trying to edge in front, trying to get the smallest of advantage. Di Salle and Dubini of Italy in second, Bozzi and Chlorinadi of Japan, of Greece rather, in third.
Yes, so the Japanese team all the way out on the right, really sailing their own race. They're going into attack at the moment, and hoping to cross the fleet and to take the control back, I think.
It's quite an aggressive. You and I both had the same thought at the same time.
Yeah,
it's an aggressive stance they've taken.
I think they're just trying to race their own race, just at the top, towards the top mark, and then they will take it on from there and defend the position. They just really think this right side is going to pay off, and at the moment, well, they're right. They're in the lead.
There seems to be just a tiny bit more pressure out there. The wind is shifting, oscillating, but I don't know. I think the Italians are out on what we call the left side of the course at the moment. They're coming in on the opposite tack. Who else is out there? The Greek team of Bozzi and Clonadrio may also be out there as well, which could be of interest.
It's close. First boat is coming from the left at the moment and the second from the right, so it's definitely the extremes that are winning at the moment. But we just need to give it a little bit more time to see which side is going to end up being the favourite side.
So it generally does work that way. If you go to an extreme, you can make a gain, but you don't get a choice when you come back. If a wind bends against you, you can't make a decision. So you get boats working the middle and then taking the decisions and hopefully getting the best. And often you see a boat come from a corner, but most of the fleet will try and work the middle if they can. They're all sort of coming centre on the course now, Evie, I think. Yeah,
They're not at the ley lines. Most of them are coming centre, that's absolutely right.
I'll write that down, got it right.
Jordan, it's a one design boat, but you're allowed to make quite a few changes, aren't you? Which makes it a pretty technical boat.
Yeah, very technical boat. So it's not like you buy everything from the manufacturer. You can go to a boat builder to buy your hull. You can go to a mast manufacturer to get your mast, and you can make your own sails or go to a different sail maker. So they have to be built to very, very, very strict tolerances. So because the level is so high, these very fine tolerances allow the sailors to adjust the boat just slightly to suit their weight or their techniques. They can also tune the rig with their side stays, with their mast ram, not mast ram, but chocks, and where they mount their mast base. There's very fine tolerances, but they can just adjust them around slightly to suit their needs, which adds to your skill as a sailor to develop that, and also makes it fairer. You know, you get to make the boat suit.
It does look at the moment that the pack that went to the left is definitely in the front at the moment.
Starting to shine.
Yeah. The 10 degree shift.
Is it going to be the Italians again?
Yeah, they are on a roll in this 470 class. But it's still very, very close. I think that's the Spanish team there on top of the screen that will tack right in front. And I think we're close to the ley line, or they're actually going towards that first mark.
Yeah, I think you're right. This is just such fine driving, just trying to keep this boat moving. The pumping there just to try and keep the speed in the boat, fan the sail. The boat to windward there, the Italian boat is going to feel that dirty air on them and they're going to slow up a little bit. So I'll just try and spot to see if they have slown up.
Yeah, a little bit. 0.4 knots.
It's what we call dirty air, Evie.
Yeah, it's a position where you don't want to be in. Actually, to say it in a simple way, the Spanish are taking away the wind from the Italians, causing them to go a little bit slower.
Our leaders coming into the top mark now. The Spanish out in front, Silvia Mas and Patricia Cantero. But it's close between them and the Italians. Very little between Benedetta Di Salle and Alessandro Dubini. The Italians out of the medal hunt, racing for pride as the Greeks round in third. And then come the overall leaders from Japan. That position still holding the Japanese in the gold medal position. Mainly because one of their nearest challengers, Mills and McIntyre, went back to start again. They're round that mark now in seventh. They're still in the hunt for a bronze medal, though, the Brits. Lecointre and Retournaz of France, round last. So the Slovenians have made up some places after starting early and having to go back and start again. Tina Mrak and Veronika Mackerel. Let's get Jenny's view of the race from the water.
You know, it's interesting out here. I'm surprised that France dropped so far down the pack. They were not one of the three boats that went back over early. So instead, the people sitting in second position just not doing well around the top mark. But it's gotten a lot lighter throughout the afternoon here. So instead of kind of the 6 to 8, even 10 knots that we saw earlier, and now feels more like 6 to 7 and dying a bit. So you can see the finesse that the ladies are using now. They're still pumping a lot, but then there's a lot of finesse needed as well. And I think we saw really well Spain 18 just pulling that out at the top mark.
Well, we're watching our leaders downwind, putting all that effort into balancing the boat. It's not just about strength, is it?
No, when the conditions are this light, as Jenny was saying, the conditions have definitely got more lighter compared to an hour ago. It's all about trying to be smooth and fluent and keeping the boat fast at all time. So it's, that's what they're trying to do. And they are really trying to stay in the lead because they were in fourth place overall and, you know, they're in the hunt for a podium place.
Well, at the moment, they're up for a silver medal if they can hold this lead. So that gives you a good bird's eye view of the chasing pack with the Brits and the French near the rear in ninth and tenth. Two teams that began the day second and third, now sitting ninth and tenth. The French at the back will still win a medal, but the Brits in front of them are out of the medal running at the moment. They need to start making up places. And the boat ride in front of them are their teammates, Seabright and Carpenter.
300 metres to get to the bottom mark. Another lap to go. Leaders at 5.44 knots, around that 5.5 knots. Everyone else about the same. So there's no speed differences. It's all very equal. No passing lanes, as we discussed, Evie. It's very tough to make a pass in this
boat. Definitely. But I do think that the British team of Mills and McIntyre will try to pull something off in that second upwind to gain some places.
Yeah, the wind looked like it was trying to go right for a second, but it's sort of dropped back. It sort of gave us a little flick, but it didn't happen. Remember, as we went around that top mark, the Spanish team just led around.
The distance between first and second coming down. But it's all about consistency now for Yoshida and Yoshioka, sitting in fourth place, but still holding on to gold.
Well, you said, Alec, that the Japanese put a lot of passion into the 470 class, second in the men's and currently lying first in the women's. I can see why they're passionate.
Yeah, they have a strong history in the class, yeah. And definitely with the Olympics in Tokyo, they're really full on in this Olympic cycle.
Right, got a shot of the bottom gate there, and these are our leaders just a few metres away from the gate. And as they're looking at it, I think they're going to pick the left side. So a growing lead between the Spanish out in front and the Italians trying to chase them down. Di Salendubini choosing to go the other way, and our overall leaders around as well, the Japanese. Flip-flopping between second and third place. The Greeks in the mix, currently in fifth. And now the Brits and the French near the back of the fleet. Mills and McIntyre. Well, they've rounded in sixth. They've made up a good couple of spaces since the top mark. Seabright and Carpenter round as well. The French are round in ninth. And still all to do for the Slovenians.
I've got to say that the wind looks like it's... Jenny was pointing out she thinks the wind's getting lighter out there. I think it's getting less stable.
Yeah,
the word
we can
I'd
see
use.
Some big changes. We saw it going from 130 to 115, so definitely bigger wind shifts than we've seen before.
And we've got a split fleet going to each side of the mark, so they'll come back together pretty quickly. It looks like they're all coming back together.
So much experience on board this British boat. And Hannah Mills, gold medalist in Rio, silver medalist at the World Championships last year, a former world champion, but a new partner in the boat in Ellie McIntyre. And it takes time to gel, but these two have been racing on the Olympic circuit all season and have been fairly consistent up near the top of the fleet every time. Right now they're sitting in eighth place, just out of the medal positions.
Yeah, there's 3 points separating them from the French team, Le Cointre and Retourna. So that means they have to catch up on two more boats if they want to claim that bronze medal.
So Mills and McIntyre will need to make at least sixth.
Well, it also depends on what the French team is doing. So if they are moving forward, then yeah, they need to pull something off, that's for sure.
Spanish really showing their mettle here, showing their calmness for such a young team. And was sixth last year in the World Championships. Well, if they continue like this, they'll be going home with silver. What a huge improvement we've seen from them over the last couple of years. And they've had a great season so far. In the top eight at all the major regattas so far. And of course, Evie, we saw them finish in the silver medal position at the World Cup Series final in Marseille just a couple of months ago. But their lead is very small right now as the Italians cross behind them. Di Salle and Dubini putting on a challenge. Italy hasn't won a medal at the World since 2010. It's not going to happen here. They're out of the podium places. They're sailing for pride, and right now the Italians can be proud of their performance here.
Yeah.
The Spanish team is not really looking to what the other teams are doing, they're just trying to sail the right shifts, and you know, they're not staying in between the mark and the Italian, so they're pretty sure that they have their own strategy that's working out for them. But it wouldn't hurt to tack back and to stay in control of the Italians, because they're only 10 meters behind.
And yeah, they're traveling pretty well too, the Italians. I'm trying to find passing lanes or little things. I'm just running through the analytics here, just trying to spot something that's going to make a difference. But they're also evenly matched at the moment. It's hard to...
Is it down to just keeping an eye out for a puff of wind somewhere? Mm. A change in the colour on the water surface?
Yeah, it's a combination of making the boat go fast at all time and keeping an eye out on the water for pressure and also on your position. Once you're in the front, you should just defend your position and make sure that you are where you need to be according to the standings. So it's a little bit of everything that you need to take care of in order to have a good race.
So they've just dropped back a bit here, the Japanese pairing. They went around that bottom mark second. According to the analytics, they've probably dropped back into fifth place. So they're just sliding back down. Haven't had the greatest run, or work, I should say. They probably came up the middle a little bit more than the other two. Not going to lay into this top mark yet, so they're all going to have to head back. So we see the tack from the Spanish team. They'd be pretty happy with their performance. They're coming up into the medals at the way they're sailing at the moment.
Yeah, and they will cross in front of the Italians.
There you go.
Yeah, there you go. And I think they will just sail towards the ley line and make the tack. Yeah, the crew really working hard there.
So this will be into the ley line.
Yes.
Top mark for the last time. Next is a run to the finish with a little reach to finish it off. So this is going to be for victory, and hopefully for them, put them up into the overall standings, second place. Good work by them. And doing it the whole way so far. Haven't been headed.
Up to this mark for the final time. One more leg. And then it's a short reach to the finish. And the Spanish now looking comfortable out in front and looking comfortable for Silva. Di Salandubini of Italy round in second. Now let's have a look at the battle for third. Mm. It's the other Spanish boat. It's going to take third, Cornudella and Lopez. And the Brits are back in the hunt here. A wow. Fantastic manoeuvre has got them into a fourth place. And the Japanese right behind them, hearing a whistle on the water.
Waiting to hear what that's about.
The Greeks round in fifth. But a good leg for Hannah Mills and Ellie McIntyre, who've moved up into fourth place, and more importantly for them, has moved them up into a bronze medal position.
They just did a little short tack at that mark, and there's plenty of ground to be made when you do those if you're switched on. So that's a very clever little move.
Yeah, so great move by Mills and McIntyre, and currently in fourth, and that puts them back in a podium position.
Wow. Gee, that's to some determination from those young ladies. That they just took an extra tiny little dig, two little tacks right at the finish. There must have been just a tiny shift or a little opportunity that they saw. Many people let those last ones pass. It's a sign of a quality team when you go for those little tiny ones. Comes the jibe. So Mills, McIntyre, well, they've only got 10 metres between the next place. So third is achievable for them. You can see it's right there, the Spanish team they're chasing.
So but there we have two boats side by side. The Japanese sitting in 10th, but holding on to gold. And just ahead of them, the British of Mills and McIntyre in 4th place and holding on to bronze.
This is going to be tough. So the Japanese are trying to run low and get an overlap. So they've got the inside position at the bottom mark. It's a long way to the to that bottom mark yet to be doing that. But all these three boats could change lead. And it looks like the Japanese are doing a really good job of it, doesn't it?
And it's not just about where Mills and McIntyre finish. It'll also depend on Le Cointre and Retournaz of France, who are currently back in 8th, just out of that bronze medal position. So it's hotting up for silver and bronze as Yoshida and Yoshioka continue downwind for the final time in 5th place. And that's enough for gold.
Yeah, I don't think the Japanese are going to lose this regatta. I think it's theirs now.
No, definitely. They have a 6-point advantage over the Spanish team of Mas de Parras and Cantero Reina. So if everything goes to plan, they will definitely hold on to that gold medal.
So the British team just trying to attack and close up on the... Our lead Spanish team is currently going to be holding the silver medal position. This coordination between the skippers and the crews is really takes a lot of time. And I've got to say, sometimes frustration, you know, when you're out there training every day and it's to the millimetre, you know, when we used to train, if you go into a jibe or a manoeuvre and you're all like 1 degree out in your body weight, we'd stop and reset, you know. You just had to, the sport of sailing is the search for perfection, and it's impossible to be perfect in sailing, you know, it's so, so hard. But that's if you want to make it to this level, you've got to execute everything perfectly. So that whole manoeuvre, you can see that skipper is adjusting and flying that spinnaker. She made a tactical decision through that jibe. She did a whole bunch of things in that one simple manoeuvre while the crew was doing other completely other things, but absolutely working together.
And it's not just perfection in your moves, it's perfection in how you set up your boat as well. And if you walk around the boat part, you'll see little notes written around the boat, little numbers that only they understand. As the British make a move here on the Spanish.
Whoa. So the Spanish had right of way, they're on starboard there, and the British are definitely closing down. So this is very, excuse me, very aggressive. We're getting close.
So Mills and McIntyre still holding their position up near the front of the fleet. They've got to finish 2 places ahead of the French. Well, they are doing at the moment. But the Spanish have been excellent this race. They put in a great performance. They've led from the very first mark, and no one is going to catch them now. Silvia Mas and Patricia Cantero head towards that finish line. Well, they can see it now. It's within their grasp. Just ahead of them, in the sun, is the finish line. They started the day in 4th place and have had a pretty good championship all round, although they've only managed 1 podium finish in qualifying. But today they were excellent. They haven't put a foot wrong, and the Spanish are going to claim victory in the medal race, and that will mean, as things stand, the silver medal for Spain here at the World Championships in Aarhus. You can see in second there the Italians, they're out of the medal running, but they've also had a good race and will also be very pleased. But not as pleased as the Spanish, Mas and Cantero. They've put on a fantastic performance, and at the moment it's enough for second. It's Spain's first podium at a world championship in 6 years. Now, what about further back? Third place. It's currently between the other Spanish team and the Brits. And the British, Hannah Mills, Ellie McIntyre, trying to close in on Cornudella and Lopez. But the Spanish will seal a third place finish. Now, Hannah Mills at the back of the boat there, looking for the finish line and looking back as well to see where the French are. But the Brits finish in fourth place, and that is enough to give them the bronze medal position. Japan crosses the line mid-fleet, but it's enough to claim their first ever World Championship victory in the 470. So celebrations for Japan, and disappointment for the French, who crossed the line out of the medals in seventh place. Greece in eighth, and then the Slovenians, who never recovered from a poor start. Tina Mrak and Veronika Mackerel have to make do with a last place finish in the medal race alongside Seabright and Carpenter of Great Britain. So an absorbing race and a great performance really from the Spanish to claim silver. But look at the joy on board that boat. Silver was the only previous podium in a World Championships in 2006 for Japan. And these women have managed to get gold and set it all up now for Tokyo 2020, surely.
Yeah, definitely a great win by Yoshida and Yoshioka. She's been sailing for a very long time, Yoshida, with a lot of different crews, and definitely a well-deserved victory for her. But I have to say, also a great comeback by Mills and McIntyre in that race. They were looking pretty bad after that start and going back, and what a miracle comeback to claim the bronze medal.
It's good for sailing too in Japan, you know, with the two 470, you know, the 470s are second and a first. It's going to help a lot with the promoting of our sport into the Olympics. It's a fantastic outcome.
Let's get reaction from the winners of the race, the silver medalists from Spain.
Felipe Dades, ladies, congratulations. Well sailed, a great week, a great race. You've now won against the, you've now gotten second again. A gold medalist, reigning bronze medalist, how does it feel?
Amazing. Everyone was pushing super hard, and so at the end, well, the medal race was everything.
It's such tough conditions this week. It's been windy, it's been light. How physically grueling is it for you as a crew on these boats?
Right now I can't even talk. Like, I need to drink water desperately. My lips are all stuck to my mouth, but it's been amazing. I could just think about, like, try to finish as best as we could. And pumping, no thinking and anything else, just I knew it was a quick race and I just had to be there just hanging some minutes, and we did as best as we could. It worked.
You have two Spanish teams in the medal race. It must be a deep squad. How does your squad work together to achieve medals?
Perfect. Like, we understand each other super good. We always fight together. We train together. They are super cool. Everything is perfect with them.
We have an amazing team with the other girls and our coach. We're so happy, and it's a medal is from all of us, not just us.
Congratulations, you guys. Well sailed.
Thank you.
Fantastic interview there from Jenny. I can't speak. My mouth is stuck together from the excitement and because she needs water. Yes, a great performance from them. They are on a real high, and we've been talking about them all season as sort of, you know, upcoming Spanish talent. Well, they've certainly achieved that here today with a silver medal. These are our gold medalists. With an exuberant celebration on the Japanese boat. This is how they cross the line. One of the best ever sailing performances for the nation of Japan. And it's gone to Yoshida and Yoshioka.
I was going to say, we mightn't be able to speak Japanese, but we certainly can read the body language.
And Aarhus loved them today.
Yes. Well done, Evie. That was a good one.
So, victory for them. But how did it come about?
Ah, lucky tack. It was a great race. So, one thing we did have was an over the line. We had the Slovenian team going over the line early, but we saw both British teams return as well. So, we had... left late was the benefit. There you can see the X flag as the team's coming back. So we saw the Slovenian team, but these two British teams didn't need to return back, and that had major regatta implications and a lot of stress for the sailors as they went back. So we saw a shifty, aggressive sort of first work. At the end, it was very much the left at the very end that sort of paid out, and we saw our team from Spain that we just had the interview from go around in first place, followed closely by the Italians. The Italians and the Spanish, the Italians having a good day today. And then our friends from Japan, we can see coming into shot as well. So they were right up close. We also had the Greek team going around in third place, but they sort of started to slide back through the race, whereas the Japanese moved up, the British moved up. We got a little bit of a split as we went around this mark. Sure, it was led by the Spanish, but the Italians went the other way, and so the fleets were starting to attack here, the Japanese coming this way as well. And they did start to move backwards slightly here, the Japanese, and it was this next beat was quite aggressive. The teams were very close together, very determined to try and make passes, and Evie pointed out that the Spanish in the lead just worried about their own race. They actually just went up there and didn't really match the fleet. They didn't try and cover the Italians. They just tried sailing the shifts. And there were a few little shifts. It was oscillating. The wind became less stable as the race went on. The Japanese did start to slide back a little bit, but they had a good lead at the end of this top mark. They dropped back to fifth. But the Spanish team continued to lead all the way. And the Italians had dropped back a little bit on the run, but they were back up in second. And then we started to see the second Spanish team come through into the third place, and then we had the big close battle here, and we saw that last little tack up there by Mills and McIntyre, which brought them right back into contention. They were off the podium at this up until this stage, and then they'd moved themselves in to contention. And we raced downwind on leg four. There were some great little crosses, some battles, some port starboard interactions, and you can see the Spanish team there really focusing on keeping that boat moving. They had good speed. They were probably the fastest boat on the water today, to tell the honest truth, when I go through the analytics. But they had a nice win. It brought them up into the silver medal position. The Italians right there behind them, probably about seventh overall if we do a quick calculation. Then the Spanish again, and Mills and McIntyre, the British team, coming in just in front of the Japanese. And that is the rest of our world championship podium crossing the line, and the joy on the Japanese sailors. And thumbs up from the British.
So, confirmation of the results for the medal race. It was a victory for the Spanish, Italy in second, and the other Spanish team in third place, with Hannah Mills and Ellie McIntyre in fourth, and our eventual gold medalists in fifth place. So this is how they finished. Gold went to the Japanese, silver to the Spanish, thanks to that great victory in the medal race. The British take bronze, and Camille Lecointe and Aloise Retournaz, who started the day second overall, miss out on the medals.